Today is Thursday, 19th of September 2019. So many things are happening in India and around the world, and we will pick a few news to unfold those stories. One important incident which happened in the Democratic Republic of Congo, which is a Central African country. There, this UN peacekeeping mission is deployed, and one of the Indian soldiers who was part of this peacekeeping mission, Lieutenant Colonel Gaurav Solanki, he met with an accident there 4 days back, and then a lot of search was conducted to find him out, and then the news, bad news came that he is no more. He has died in the lake, the Q lake. And he and his companions in the army contingent there, they had gone for the kayaking trip in the lake. Now, what this this problem in Congo is, and what for the UN peacekeeping mission is. If you look into the problems which persist in Congo, this is a country which is conflict affected for a very, very long time. And from 1960 only the country has been in trouble, and the UN peacekeeping mission is being deployed there again and again. Firstly, it happened in 1960 and it continued till 1964. Again, the problem happened because of two civil wars which happened. So, in the wake of the second civil war in Congo, again the UN peacekeeping mission was deployed there. And at the moment, there are more than 8,000 soldiers deployed as part of the UN peacekeeping mission, out of which more than 2,000 Indian soldiers are there. This was about Congo, but then what this whole UN peacekeeping mission is, and why these soldiers are deployed. So what happens whenever any part of the world there is some strife, some conflict, some civil war, or any unstable situation is there, then the UN can decide to send the peacekeeping force. So, till now, many countries are there. If we look into the current figures, at the moment, across 4 continents, in 14 countries, the UN peacekeeping mission is deployed. So, if we look into in terms of the number of the soldiers, approximately 1,10,000 soldiers are deployed in these 14 countries. And if we look into the contribution of India towards these peacekeeping missions, since India became a member of the UN, since that time India has served as part of this these kind of missions in 43 countries, and our soldiers to the number of 1,80,000 soldiers have served as part of the peacekeeping missions. At the moment also, whatever number of this peacekeeping mission soldiers are deployed in different countries, almost 1/3 are from India. Like in Congo itself, there are forces comprising 30 countries. And India has the largest participation in that peacekeeping force. If we look into as to how much these peacekeeping forces have been successful and what kind of jobs they perform, like if we look at from the Indian perspective, from India, the army personnel are deployed as part of these missions. Then even the police means from India, Central Reserve Police Force, CRPF people are deployed. Also in certain cases, observers, the top people, top officials from India, they are deployed as part of these missions as observers or even as advisors. Besides Congo, there is another important country where Indian forces have served, that is Sudan. So in 2011, this Sudan was bifurcated and another country emerged on the scene, which we know as South Sudan. So in the maintenance of peace and in putting the things in a stable manner in Sudan also, there also India played a very key role. Now, another important news which has drawn our attention is India's border with Nepal and the decision of the government of India to put a restriction on the entry of citizens from 12 countries through Nepal. Now, if we look at India-Nepal borders and India-Nepal relationship, we have open borders with Nepal. India has open borders, in fact, with two countries, Nepal and Bhutan. With Nepal, we have a border of 1,751 kilometers. With Bhutan, we have a border which is approximately 700 kilometers. Between India and Nepal, the border is touching Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Bihar, and West Bengal. So since the borders are open, and all this has happened due to a treaty which India and Nepal entered in 1950, which is known as India-Nepal Treaty of Peace and Friendship. So it's practically, it's an open movement between India and Nepal. And this has been one reason which is in effect a security threat to India, because a lot of Pakistani people, terrorists also entered into India by road. Indian government has decided to put restriction on the entry by road from Nepal belonging to 12 countries, which included Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq, Syria, Ethiopia, Palestine. So all such countries are there. And at the same time, Nepal government has put a restriction on the entry of Pakistani nationals in Nepal through visa on arrival. So this visa on arrival facility, which earlier Nepal was giving to Pakistani national, that has been scrapped. So that is definitely will give a boost to Indian security situation, and that will also put pressure on Pakistan as far as the current scenario is concerned in the world, and as far as India-Pakistan relations at the moment are concerned. So that is all in this edition.